Hello friends, welcome to the Mind Touch Tech YouTube channel. My name is Prince and this is our 29th JavaScript lecture. And in this lecture, we will study about the very good and very most important topic of the JavaScript, that is form validation in JavaScript. That what are form validation, what is the use of form validation and how to validate a form in JavaScript, friends. This is very good and very interesting lecture of the JavaScript. If you watch that lecture full, then I'm damn sure that you will definitely know about the form validation, friends. So let us start, friends. So friends, first of all, we have to know about that what are these validations. What is validation? So validations are the preventions that you can apply on anything. You can apply the validation to your own body, friends. Like if you don't want to eat egg, then you can apply the validation of it. If you don't want to drink cold drink, then you can apply the validation of it. And if you have applied the validation, then you will not be able to drink that cold drink or eat that egg, friends. So similarly, in the JavaScript, you can apply the validation to any form, friends. Like, all you use Facebook. Okay, in the Facebook, what do you have to do first? You first have to enter your mobile number or the email address. And after that, you have to enter your password, friends. Then you have to press on the login button. And suppose you have entered your email address, right? But you have entered the wrong password. And then you click on the login button, then it will show you message that is the please enter the right password or please enter the valid password, friends. So these type of validations are applied by the use of the JavaScript. So let us see how to apply the validation in the JavaScript. So I will take the example of a simple form in which I will apply the validation, friends. So first I have to make a form. So to create a form, I have to write here the form tag, friends. So I have to write here form tag and then the close of the form tag. I hope that you have the basic knowledge of the form. If you don't have the basic knowledge of the form, then I recommend you please visit my previous lecture, that is the basic of the form. So in that form tag, there can be two attributes, that is the two properties. First is the action, second is the method of the form. So first I have to write here the action of the form equals to, and in the double quotes, what is that action, friends? That is, after submitting the form data, the control will transfer to the another page, friends. So we have to give the path of the another page in that, between that double quotes, friends. So for that, I have to create the another page, friends. So to create another page, click on the file, new file, again click on file, and then save as, save it in the same location, friends. And let us give that name, that is the mypage.html. Okay, now let us give the message to that page, that is the h1 tag again. Close of the h1 tag, that is after submitting the form data, this message will be shown to you, friends. So let's give the message, that is the thanks for your feedback, and we will contact you soon. This is the message, friends. Control plus s. Now what you have to do here, you just have to give here the path of that my page here between the double quotes, friends. So I have to write here the name of that, so my page .html. I just have to give here the name because I have saved both the file in the same location, friends. This is the reason for that. Okay, now let's give the method to that. That is a method is equals to there are two methods, friends. The first is our get method and the second is our post method. I will tell you the difference between the get method and the post method, friends. So first of all, let's write here the post method, friends. That is the post method. Okay, now I will create my simple form, friends, in which I will create the three fields. The first is our name field, then the email field, and then the feedback field. And the last will be our submit button. So for that, we have to write here the paragraph, close of the paragraph. You can also create the form by the use of the table, friends. But here I'm using here the paragraph, friends. Okay, now let's write here the name field. So name, and we have to write here the input type is equals to text. Why text? Because I'm going to create a text field, friends. Now let us give the ID to that text field. That is the ID is equals to suppose name, friends. You can give any name to that ID, friends. It depends on you. Okay. Now let us create the same for the email address. So we again have to write here the paragraph, close of the paragraph, and I have to write here the email. That is for the email here. And again, I have to write here the, like here, I have to write here the input type is equals to text, friends. Notice here, friends, I have written here the type is equals to text. You can also write here the type is equals to email for the email. But I have written here the type is equals to text. Why? because I am going to apply the validations by the use of the JavaScript to that email field, friends. That's why I have written here the type is equals to text, friends. Okay, now let us give the ID to that email. So I have to write here the ID is equals to suppose email, friends. Also, you can give here any ID, friends. You can give here any name of the ID, but I have given here the meaningful name for that, friends. Okay, now let us give the break for the next line here. That is the break for that also, and break for that also for the next line, friends. Control S, open that file from there. It's opening, friends. Now you can see that, friends, the two fields has been created. One is for the name and the second is for the email, friends. Now let us create for the feedback section. So for that, we again have to write here the paragraph, close of the paragraph, and let us write here the feedback. That is, we are going to create a feedback section, feedback. And after that, we again have to give here the break tag. And after that, we again have to write here the what? Text area. We have to write here the text area, friends. Text area, opening of the text area and the closing of the text area. Control S, Control R. Now you can see here that the feedback section has been created, friends. Now let us increase the height of that feedback section. So to increase the height of that, we have to increase the rows. So you have to give here the rows is equals to 4. Okay, Control S, Control R. You can see here that the height has been increased. Now let us apply, make the submit button here. So for that, we again have to write here the paragraph, close of the paragraph, and we have to write here the input type is equals to submit. Okay, Control S, Control R. Now our form has been completed, friends. Now our main concept will be started. Now what I want, friends, I want to apply the validation to that form, friends. Which type of validations I want to apply to that form, friends? Like if I enter my name here, friends, I have entered my name, and suppose I have forget to enter my email ID, and when I click on the submit button, then it will show you a message that is the please enter your email ID, friends. And suppose I have entered my email ID also, and I forget to enter the feedback, and then I click on the submit, then it will also show you the message that is the please enter your feedback, friends. And suppose I have entered my feedback also, friends, but I have entered the invalid email address, friends. I didn't apply here the @gmail.com, friends. Then it will again show you the message that is the please enter the valid email address, friends. Okay, that's about it, friends. So let us see how to apply the validation in the JavaScript. This is important, friends. Let us see. Focus on that, friends. Okay. We have to give here the ID to that text area also. So ID is equals to suppose feedback. Okay. Now forget about that, friends. Forget about that HTML coding. Now our main concept will be started. We have to write here the script tag for the JavaScript coding and then the close of the script tag. Okay. What is our first step? Our first step is to make a function. I will make a function because I have to call that function by onSubmit event, friends. So I have to write here the function and the name of the function, suppose my form is the name of the function. Okay. And then braces of the function, friends. Okay. Now what I have to do, I just have to call that function here by onSubmit. So I have to write here the onSubmit. That is by clicking on the submit button, this function will be called, friends. That is this function will be called, friends. Okay, so for that we have to write here the first of all the return and then the name of the function, that is the my form, and then the braces of the function and then the semicolon you can apply here, friends. So what I did here, friends, I have just called that my form named function here in the HTML by on submit event, friends. Okay, when I click on the submit button, then this function will be called, friends. And why I have applied here the return keyword, friends, I will tell you about that, friends. Okay, so first of all, friends, what I have to do, I just have to, our first step is what? Our first step is to access these ID in the JavaScript, friends. So to access these ID, I have to write here the document.getElementById. GetElementById. Okay, and after that, in the double quotes, we have to write here the name of the ID that we want to access. So I want to access the name here, friends. So I have to give here the name, that is the name of the ID name, and after that the dot value. What is that dot value? What is that value? It means that we are going to access the value of that name field, friends. So what is that value? You can see here, friends, if I enter here the prints, this prints is the value of that text field, friends. It means we are going to access the prints here, friends. So whatever the value user will enter in that text box, that value will be accessed here by the use of the dot value, friends. That's why we have written here the dot value friend. It is the true user, the value friends. Okay. Now let us put that in a variable so that I can apply here the condition. So we have to give here the variable name, that is the name. You can give any name to that variable friend. It depends on you friends. Okay. So now I will tell you that why I have written here the return keyword friends. It means that return me returning any value friends. It means that this function is containing the values friends. And if I write here the return keyword, then it will, that this function will return the value of that friends. If you don't write here the return keyword, then it will not return the values friends. I have also made the separate lecture for the return keyword. You can also watch my lecture for the return keyword friends. Okay, that's why I have written here the return keyword friends. That is the returning the value friends. Okay, so again I have to access the ID, that is the email address, that is the email. So for that, again I have to write here the document dot get element by ID, and after that the name of the ID, that is the email, and then dot value. Okay friends, that's what it. And let us access the feedback, that is the, again the document dot get element by ID, and after that name of the ID, that is the feedback friends, and then dot value. Okay, now let us put that again in the variable. So we have to write here the variable. Name of the variable is suppose email. Okay, you can give any name to that variable, and then again the name of the variable suppose here feedback friends. Feedback, that's what it friends. Okay, so I have accessed these IDs here in the JavaScript friends. This is about that friends. Okay, now let us just print the value of that. So I will show you the demo. So print that value, you have to write here the alert. So I want to access print the name, so I have to write here the name. And after that, I have to write here the return false. What does this return false means? I will tell you that what does this return false means. It means that our coding will be stopped there, friends. Okay, control plus S, control plus R. Okay, if I write here the prints, when I click on the submit button, now you can see here that the message has been shown, that is the prints, friends. Now when I click on the OK, now you can see here that it is not going to the another page friends, because we have written here the return false friends. And if we don't write here the return false friends, control plus S, control plus R, write here the prints, click on submit button, you can see here the message has been shown prints, click on the OK. Now you can see here that it has gone to the another page, that is the thanks for your feedback friends, we will contact you soon friends. Which page? That we have mentioned here, that is the my page.html by the use of the action friends. So that's why we have to write here the return false friends, so to prevent it to go to the next page friends. Okay, control R, wait for a while, control R, name here prints, submit prints. Okay, not going to the next page friends. This is about that friends. That's why we have to write here the return false friends. Okay, now let us apply here the condition. Our main concept will be started here friends. Focus on that what I'm going to tell you friends. Focus on that carefully. I have to write here the conditions friends. Which type of condition? So first of all, I have to write here the if friends. So we have to write here the if, that is the if our name field is empty. Empty means that is the this type of double quote. This type of double quote shows that the name field is empty. If our name field is empty, then a message should be shown. What does this empty means? Like if we don't enter any name here in that field, friends. If this name field is empty, like we didn't enter, if we enter here name, then it is not empty. But if we don't enter any name here, then this is empty. But so if this is empty, then a message should be shown to us, that is the alert. Message should be shown to us, that is the please enter your name. That's what it press. And after that we have to write here the return false that I have already told you about that friends. Control S, control plus R. Okay, if I don't write anything in the name field and when I click on the submit button, now you can see here that friend, it is showing us the message, that is the please enter your name friend. This is about that friends. This is the type of the validation that I have applied on the name field friends. Okay, now let us apply the validation for the email field. So again, I have to write here the else if condition, that is the else if, again, if the email is also empty, email is equals to double quote, that is the empty, then a message should be shown to us, that is the alert, that is the please enter your email ID. That's what it friends. And after that, we have to write here the return false friends, return false. Control S, Control R, If I write here my name, Prince, okay. If I don't write here the email address, then click on the submit button. Now you can see here that it is showing us the message that is please enter your email ID, friends. That's button, friends. Now let's do for the feedback section. So again, I have to write here the after that, there is the else if feedback is also empty, feedback is equals to empty, then it should show us the message that is the alert, that is the please enter your feedback. That's pretty friend. Feedback, okay. And after that we have to write here the return false, friend. Return false. That's pretty friends. Okay, else if, and after that else these conditions are satisfied, else then if these conditions are not satisfied, then a message should be printed that is the return. There, so we have to write here the return true, then it will go to the next page, friends. I will show you that about that, friends. Okay, it means that if all the fields are, if all the fields, that is the, it all the fields are not empty, then it will return you the true value, friend. It means that it will go to the next page, that is the mypage.html, friends. Okay, now let's test it. Control S, Control plus R. Okay, if I don't write here anything, like you can see that it is showing us the message that is the please enter your name, friends. Okay, if I write here the name, okay, I have written here the name. If I click on the submit, now you can see it is showing us the message that is the please enter your email ID, friends. Okay, that's my difference. And if I write here the email ID that is the PP only, suppose, click on the submit button, now you can see that it is showing us the message that is the please enter your feedback, friends. Click on the okay, and if I again write here the hello, click on the submit, now you can see that it is, so it is going to the next page, that is the thanks for your feedback, we will contact you soon. Why? Because we have written here the return true, friends. Okay, if you write here the return false, friend, that it will not go to the next phase, friends. Return false, Control S, Control R. Okay, wait for a while, Control R, write here the name, email, that is the PP, and message, that is the hello. Click on submit button, it is not going to the next page, friend. That's why we have, because we have written here the return false, we have to write here the return true, friend. This is about that, friends. Okay, Control S, Control R, Prince, email address PP, okay, and hello. Okay, that's now there is a problem, friends. Okay, now we will apply the validation to that email address, friends. Okay, because we can see that it is considering that PP is an email address, it is not an email address, it is not a proper email address. Okay, so to validate that email ID, also email address, email field, we have to write here again. We have to write here, that is like that. What do you have to do? We just have to write here a variable, that is the variable valid, suppose valid email named arable. So friends, here you just have to copy paste here a coding. I will give you the coding in the description. Open that file. You just have to paste that, Control plus C, and then Control plus V. We have to paste that in here. I have put that code in my description. You can check that code in my description, friends. Okay, so you have to give here the code like that. That is the very valid email name variable, and then the this type of coding, friends. Okay, then again we have to apply here the condition that is after the email, that is here, like just after the email, that is the else if valid email dot test. Here test is a function to test the email, friends. Which variable you want to test, which text field you want to test, we have to give it the name of that. That's the email. I want to test the email, friends. Okay, and then equal to false, friends. What does this mean? Don't be confused on that. What does this mean, friends? We have applied here the test function, friends. Which field we want to test here, which variable we want to test, we have to give here in the text field, friends. Okay, to which you want to text here, that is to valid email, friends. Okay, that is the first is our valid email. Okay, and then test, and then to which you want to test here, and then equal to false. It means that the if this email, like this email field is false, that is this email field is not equal to the valid email. What is the valid email? This is the valid email, friends. This is the valid email. Okay, if that email is not equals to that valid email, then it will show you the message that is the please enter the please alert, that is please enter the valid email address. Please enter valid email ID. That's what it means. Okay. And then semicolon. And after that, the return false is must. Return false. Control S. Control R. Right here. Prince. Right here, PP. Hello. click on the submit button, you can see here that it is showing us the message that is the please enter valid email address, email ID, friends. And if you write here the @, this is not a valid email address also. Click on submit, you can see here that it is showing us the please enter valid email ID, friends. Okay, and if you write here the @, right like that, write here the @ gmail.com. Now this is the valid email ID, friends. Submit. Now you can see that it is going to the next, friends. It means it is the valid email ID, friends. So this is the email validation that we have applied here. Now focus on that. I'm going to give you a quick review of that. What I did here, friends, don't be confused on that. First of all, I have created a form. Okay, form, that's about done. Okay, and in that I have given the action for the next page, and then a method, that is the post and the on submit. I will show you the difference with the method and the get method and the post method in my next lecture, friends. So okay, on submit I have called that function, that is the my form here, by using the return keyword. And in that function I have first accessed these IDs. Okay, and that in these IDs then I have applied the condition, if name is empty then this message will be shown to you, that is the please enter your name and the return false. And after that, else if email field is empty, then this message will be shown to us, that is the please enter your email ID and then the return false. And after that again, here else if feedback is empty, then this message will be shown to us, that is the and the return fields, else return true, friends. Okay, and after that I have applied the validation to the valid email. So I have created a valid email, and then we have put that code. I have given that code in my description. You can copy that code from the description, folks. Okay, and after that I have applied the condition here, like the else if after the email, that else if valid email dot test, test is the function that will test the email, and in that text field braces I have given the test email that I want to text the email to from that valid email. If that text email, if the email is not equal to the valid email, that is that code, then it is false, then it is showing us the message that is the please enter valid email ID and then return false, friends. That's about it, friends. Okay, I hope you have understood there, friends. So I think it is enough for today. So if you have any doubt, then you can comment me, please. And if you like my video, you can subscribe my channel. So thank you, take care, bye bye.